Wall student.
It is good to see you, V.
Seems pretty, secluded here.
It is appropriate for such a secret meeting.
What the hell happened? Look close to awful.
You see a man robbed of his implants, money, and dignity. Look well. It is not all bad. I am mostly unnoticed in the streets.
Friend you mentioned here?
Oda? He should be here any moment now.
Willing finally to give me the spec on him?
He's Hanako-sama's bodyguard.
Hanako Arasaka's? From the carrier at anchor in the bay? Saburo's daughter?
Yes, and if he believes you, we'll next meet with her.
Sure you can trust him?
Yes.
Convincing. Very.
I have nothing to lose. Is that better?
Worse? Because I got plenty to lose.
By God, huh? A good sign. He is usually camouflaged.
Takemura-san.
Oda.
Is this her? Your thief?
She's my witness, V.
Can speak for myself, you know.
So speak. I have been told you know things.
Not gonna like what I'm about to say. I need a guarantee I'm safe here.
You are. You have it.
V, you can trust Oda.
All right, then. Kompeki Plaza. I was there the night it happened. Looked like your typical family quarrel until Yorinobu lunged at Saburo and started choking.
Silence! Not one word more. You will bring death to your door.
But it is the truth. Hanako-sama must hear it.
My one concern is to keep her safe. In this city forgotten by the gods.
Is she in danger?
Now? No. Yet during the parade to honor Arasaka-sama, most certainly.
I bring you this witness to his murder. And you dare to worry about the silly parade? Fool!
Correct. Unlike you, I have not yet failed to keep my oath to do my
duty. But you can't ignore the truth!
You will regret those words.
The only thing I regret is that I came here to meet you.
There is a price on your head. I do you a favor now.
Sorry, but this gonna take much longer.
I do you a favor now by not cutting it off and taking it straight to Yorinobu-sama. What would you do now, were you in my place?
I do no favors. I would deliver your head to Yorinobu-sama.
Consider yourself lucky that I am not
you. Oda!
What?
We're talking about a guy who killed his father to seize control of Arasaka. Gonna take an interest in this or not?
I will not. But I will let you leave this place, this city, unharmed. If I see either of you again, I will not be so lenient.
Be very careful. My friend, we are all so far from home.
Good fucking riddance. One Arasaka whack job is already plenty.
Fine friend there. Got any more?
Alas, only him.
Well, can't say we didn't try.
We tried, yes. and obtain something useful.
Hmm. How do you figure that?
What Oda said. They return to Tokyo after the parade. Do you not see the parade? It is our chance, perhaps. If, somehow, we can get to Hanako-sama, we must do a proper reconnaissance first. We'll need a precise map of Japantown.
Hold on.
It is your turn to call on friends. Do you know a fixer who could help?
Hang on. Not so fast. Make it sound as easy as hacking a schism. But you said yourself, Hanako's got the tightest security in all Night City.
Correct. That is why I wish for you to contact us with the local fixer.
Now just the fixer, Dame. Wakako Okada. Runs a pachinko parlor on Jig-Jig Street.
We must pay this woman a visit. Will you join me?
Sure, why not?
Jig-Jig Street. What is this name?
Just a Night City name.
Beware, you mock me too often.
Until you've loved a lot.
Any idea what's going on at Arasaka?
Only what I can surmise from what I see on TV. Yorinobu and his puppets grin at the cameras and insist that everything is under control. But the wider the smile, the bigger the lies.
You all right, Goro?
Yes. Why the sudden concern?
Just asking. Does everything with you have to have an ulterior motive?
I apologize. That came off wrong. I am simply not used to such questions. People like me, either we are doing well, or we are in a grave.
Shaking Night City, your man Stan here. Say goodbye to your favorite booth.
Something that'll keep you wet for hours.
Ooh, how I miss the sun.
Rogue, my sweet. This has got to be a misunderstanding. I've no idea who jumped your team, but the claws? No, never. My boys know their place. I'm sorry, got to go. I have guests. V, so nice to see you. And your charming friend is?
Happened to be working together, that's all.
Takemura Goro desu. Okada-san, owai dekite kouhei desu.
Ah, a true gentleman. Ah, shame only that he's being hunted by all Arasaka's tin soldiers. And you, V, bring him to my door. give me one reason why I shouldn't notify the proper authorities right away.
Would have already made the call if you intended to. Simple. You're curious to see what we got.
So tell me, and mark well, I still have my phone at hand.
Need intel on the parade that's scheduled to come through Japantown.
So, it's Arasaka. Again. What I fail to understand is, why come to me? Did Mr. Deshawn not come to the phone? I'm waiting. You wanted to say something?
Goro, remind me why Dex's fat, backstabbing ass is currently indisposed.
He's deceased.
Butchered and dumped at a landfill by some Arasaka goon. Real shame, that.
That a threat I detect?
No threat, no. Asked why I couldn't reach Dex. I answered. Just facts, nothing more.
Good. Because you would then have to join him.
Okada-san, our intentions are honorable. We need just information. It is a matter of life and death.
Everything's on the shards.
How much does this cost? My pockets are empty.
Clearly. My gift to you, it's free.
Okada-san, what is free often proves most costly.
Gonna take them or not?
For free. You sure?
Got my reasons, but patience, I got none. Japantown. Whole district is to be sealed off for the parade. Dashi platforms, the main attraction. They'll fly this way, high above street level. Along the parade route, balconies, footbridges, and vantage points affording good views. Hanako Arasaka, the guest of honor, will deliver her speech from the largest float. She'll do this exactly here. Got no idea about security, but given recent events, expect it to be tight. Our last parade? Arasaka undercovers infiltrated the crowd. Not to mention a smattering of sharpshooters, drones. And if that's not enough fun for one day, a net runner, one at least. They use the city CCTV to observe everything. Main access point, here. It's an old automated control center. If you ask me, most useful by far. At the end, the floats afloat out of Japantown, and we'll be left with trash up to our elbows that no one will collect. That's it. It's all I have.
It must be enough.
Then go. Be on your way.
Not at all curious what we're going to all this trouble for?
Blissful ignorance has served me well. In any case, I'll find out soon, won't I?
Thanks, Wakako.
We appreciate this, Okada-san. Delightful, mature woman. This information, it could be just what we need. But I will try to investigate further. I will stay here some time and call some associates. The moment I learn something new, I will let you know.
Stay safe, Goro.
You as well. Until next time. I do not understand. Does Arasaka not have enough of its own people?
Look around, sir. Things are heating up in the city. Zoots know one spark's all it takes.
He's got the gift of the gab. Can't be denied, but I need to steal your buddy for a sec.
What are you? There's no time to waste, B.
Goro, good to see you.
As it is to see you, B. I acquired some information of my own. Do you know who most wished to honor Arasaka-sama with the parade? His murderer. The irony makes me sick.
Still don't see how this gets us anywhere.
I have had an idea. Look to the sky. The dash floats will pass precisely this way. If I could just get onto Hanako-sama's float, I could speak with her in private.
Get there how?
Why jump? Of course.
Expectations way too high, Goro. Couldn't pull that off even if you had your fancy implants.
I have thought of a solution. While you are occupied with your shady dealings, I learned more about the floats. They are all kept in one place. Arasaka Industrial Park. It is there that they prepare them. We need only to break into the compound, find the right float and inject a virus into its system. You will then be able to disable any security before I sneak inside. B?
Lots of ways to skin this particular cat, you know. Gonna need...
I know what you need. It is taken care of. I have an infected shard. It was not cheap, but the man who sold it to me guaranteed it will work.
Where'd you get this shard?
Across the canal.
Kabuki. Might actually be half-decent soft then. And if it isn't, got a few tricks up my sleeve too.
This is good to know. Let us move on. To take control of the float is one thing, but not all. The security concerns me, the snipers especially. I will be an easy target. But I may have an answer. Okada-san mentioned the city carrier. If we gain access to them, we will see exactly where the snipers are. You can deal with them as I advance.
Sounds like a plan.
You agree just like that? The risks are considerable.
Yeah, well, getting more and more used to that.
And now, what would you say to a small test? We must try the shard. The camera control room is in front of us. You must get inside and infect the network. That is all.
Uh-huh. And in the meantime, you'll do what? Crack open a can of suds?
I will not touch alcohol. At work, I will watch your back. Now, get to it. There's no time to waste, B.
It worked.
And?
Done. System's ours.
The shard works. Good. The easy work we have done. To break into Arasaka Industrial Park will not be such a bed of roses. But before we discuss that... Sid, I have not eaten since yesterday. Give me the best on the menu.
I highly recommend the yakitori today.
Anything that isn't local, please.
See you tomorrow.
Can't believe I'm saying this, but this Sokka scum might actually prove useful. He's a well-trained dog, needs orders, that's all. And when he outlives his purpose, we'll flatline him.
He's not on his A-game, sure. But even without implants, he could decommission us easily.
Where's that come from? Ever seen him in action?
No, just no. The way he walks, look in his eye.
We'll come back to this later.
What is this?
Hey, yakitori.
Okay, I have laid the plan. One, we break into Arasaka Industrial Park. One and a half, we hack Hanako-sama's float. Two, during the parade, with my help, you eliminate any snipers. Three, I get onto the float. Four, I convince Hanako-sama of the truth.
Forgot five. Oda zeroes us and pisses on our corpses. He won't ever be less than a foot away from Hanako.
Oda would not dare raise his hand against me.
What about me?
That is a different matter. I would advise you to watch your distance.
Well, sounds like a suicide run, but done dumber shit than this, so...
Things even more stupid than stealing from Arasaka.
None dumber yet, no. Set the bar pretty high with that one.
Now, we part. Reconnaissance is required.
What are you doing? Don't let him
off. You're a stranger in a strange land. Going with you.
True. And you with your hands, skills, mind of a thief. Agreed. This we will do together.
Cook! Louder! Louder!
Decided to double the amount of our active night city security forces. President Myers has called this
he
a breach.
He eliminated the last obstacle between himself and complete power.
And they
surrendered it to
him. Tell me then, what do we call the murder of my father? Was that not a provocation? Was that not a...
Arasaka. An empire built to last. Before Yorinobu set fire to it from the inside, all of this began with him. The factions, power struggles, all of this. Ksa!
Got factions inside Arasaka? What are they?
There are three. Kiji, Hato, and Taka. Kiji longs for stability. The old order. They are united behind Hanako-sama. The liberal wing, Hato, support Michiko-sama, Saburo's granddaughter. I know little about her. And then there is Taka, treacherous thugs who support Yorinobu. Not to mention even smaller factions.
Tell me about him some other time. Where's Yorinobu's rebellious streak come from?
No one knows this.
Perhaps soon I shall ask him in person.
Why'd Saburo tolerate it all? Can't get my head around it. Could have kept his son on a short leash.
Arasaka-sama was a strong and disciplined man. The strongest man I have ever known. And yet, at a critical moment, he showed a weakness.
For Yorinobu?
For his daughter. When Yorinobu fooled his band of hounds, declared war on his own family, Arasaka-sama could have crushed him with one word. Yet he did not, for he did not wish his daughter to suffer. When Yorinobu returned, his tail between his legs, she persuaded her father to give him a second chance. Do you understand? Hanako-sama saved Yorinobu from the consequences of his deeds.
Feels like that's about to change. As long as we get Hanako to believe our version of events. Conscience could also come into play. Assuming she's got one.
We must reach her first. Will you join me?
Sure, why not?
Let us go from here.
I hope you enjoyed it. Please come again.
Sawdust and plastic.